Intro on Mr. Sriheri. He has nearly 13 years of experience in the automotive industry, fundamentally on the plastic engineering, simulation, injection molding, plastic material, tool development, etc. He is an active participant in design and tooling solutions with the support of simulation tools like Autodesk Moldflow. And he is an active member of our Moldflow community, India, and he has presented a lot of technical topics on Moldflow user conferences many a times, and today we have the privilege of having you for the Autodesk University. Thank you. See you.
Hello, everyone. Before going into the actual case study, I just wanted to brief about this software, Autodesk Moldflow. I'm using this software ever since 2005, when Autodesk never acquired that software. It was Moldflow 5.0. And Autodesk came into picture maybe in 2010. And it has enhanced in every way, like in terms of solver solutions, in terms of accuracy, in terms of correlation studies, and in terms of actual simulation results, what we get out of this Autodesk Moldflow software. So I just wanted to know how many of you really know or interacted before with the Moldflow engineers? Very few. Yeah, this is an injection molding simulation software where we can take all the input parameters from the injection molding machine right into the software. We can simulate the results, and we can look out for the output as what is the quality of the part in terms of your warpage, first of all, in terms of your aesthetic defects, in terms of dimensional requirements, in terms of your requirements with respect to the machine that we're going to use for final molding. And last but not the least, what is the cycle time we can predict out of this exercise? So altogether, it is a injection molded tool for 1K, we can say 2K, or insert molding. There are a lot of application in Autodesk Moldflow. It is a vast with respect to the technology it includes, and we are going to focus on purely the metal molding or injection molding in this. And case study we are having today is how Autodesk Moldflow software can be utilized to solve the process failures. So here the process doesn't mean that the injection molding process, but process mean any secondary process like chrome plating, like painting, etc., which is after the molding. Okay, so your part is ready, it is going for the secondary process, and you come with some serious issues which can be solved through the Moldflow inference at that point of time. Okay, so I am representing Marquardt India there into the mechatronic solutions. Okay, we are into the switch applications for the various automotive interiors, haptic switches, and that of touch panels, that of instrumental panels, that of control panels. And we are high quality part sustaining with this product application, and we are far with the cutting edge technology that we are using today. And we can say that we have over 90 years of experience in the field of mechatronics application. We have the core potential to say we are the mechatronic specialist in this kind of applications. So Marquardt, they started in 1925. Johannes Marquardt and Jonas Marquardt, they togetherly formed a family business so as to have the special plant for electrical needs and fine mechanics. And the journey started so as to have the first generation in 1965 for the Marquardt business family. And they entered into the plant in Rydheim in 1969. They've spread or expanded to the US in 1980. And they had a power tool application ready in 1992. Continuing with the same innovation journey, they entered into the automotive businesses in 1997 with the driver authorization systems, that up into the HMI systems. Then you can see into the control panels, sensors and actuators, complex system integration. This is an electrical gear shifter for BMW. And it was developed in 2007. It's first of its kind of application, which is very critical with respect to the vehicle safety and that of functioning. Okay, now after that, we are into the battery management system, as the world is going ahead with the electrical mobility. We're already in since 2014. So we call it as a, we are pioneer and we are specialist in terms of, and we are right with the technology that is going ahead in the today's trend. So in 2005, we are 90 years old company with offices in 19 locations worldwide in 13 countries. With the four continents, we office in Pune for engineering center. We have a small manufacturing plant in Mumbai. And we do utilize this mold flow ever since start of this driver authorization system project in maybe 1997. So it started using mold flow right since 2000. And it was a very initial phase of mold flow where we had an application in the driver authorization system, in operating components like I told you that gear shifter, in battery management system, into sensors of actuators, and into the human and machine interfaces. Okay, so these are the domain we specially work in. And as far as mold flow is concerned, we have two licenses, one in Germany, one in India. And we have the utilization for the support for new development components, then troubleshoot the molding problems. Whatever molds are running, if there are aesthetic problems, there are functional issues, there are problems with respect to the field issues that we are able to solve through the mold flow, the utilization of mold flow. Then study of shrinkage variation and the warp results. This is very, very useful for the dimensional requirement. We have the parts in the accuracies with the microns. And in that case, it's very, very important to have the shrinkage study of the part with respect to material selected. Then evaluate field problems, evaluate validation problems. This also is, the software is also useful in kind of utilizations. And today we are going to talk about how we can evaluate process failures through the mold flow. Okay. So we have a product. The overall agenda is whatever the product is failing under the process called painting or lacquering. We will go into this agenda of having product overview of that. What are the engineering challenges into that particular product? Then what is the problem into the painting or lacquering process, which is always done into the control environment? Okay. Next is how mold flow can infer this problem. How mold flow can be utilized so as to have the approach towards the solution for this problem. And then what is the conclusion throughout the exercise of the mold flow, and what is the current status of the problem? So this is an overview and agenda that is take away, we're going to take out of this discussion. So it is a bi-push SOS model. It is a product application for one of our OEM called PSA. And this bi-push SOS model has an application for the emergency or crisis situation. You are driving and into the situation of crisis where you are not able to come out of that situation. Maybe you are met in an accident or the bad environment, anything like that. If you press this SOS button or band call machine while sitting inside the vehicle, it will go to the Google Map Management System, where that rescue team can identify your location and people will help to reach, help out to reach you. Okay. So this SOS and band call application is one of the very important safety features so as to come out of the crisis situation, and it should have all the product functionality and durability requirements suggested by the customer, and that of prominent light illumination requirement as per the customer specification. I mean, we have the graphics illumination for this knob and the indicator for this button and the band call illumination. Okay. So this is the product. If you see what are the components into it, there is a SOS knob. It is red punted. Okay. And it is having light indicator. The SOS symbol and that of the indicator is lasered after the painting, and the knob is 3K molded. Next is your bi-push band call. It is 1K molded. Actuators so as to pass the light and avoid leakage of the light out of your system. Then housing to return all the parts and have the required haptic function for the switch. Then the silicon mat to have the IP requirement, satisfy the IP requirement for the product, as well as to have the required haptic force into the component. The PCB as an electronic component and that of interface for the socket, so as to have the connectivity between the product and that of vehicle. So what are the engineering challenges? So first challenge is SOS knob design, which is 3K molded. The requirement for the knob design that we have separate color illumination from the indicator, that is red, and for the SOS lettering, we have the white illumination. So there should not be any light leakage around the indicator. If someone thinks that we can mold the light pipe separately, we can press fit, but around the clearance, there will be light illumination or the leakage that is not acceptable to the customer. Then no light mixing between the two. Indicator and SOS areas, illumination areas very close together. If two LEDs are glowing from the PCB right below the knob, then the two colors of light from the LED should not mix with each other, though the actuator is common. So we should have a separator design in the black component so that there is no mixing of light. Okay. And then with this all requirement, one can think of this part to be designed for 3K molding technology. And it cannot be molded with the insert molding at that of 1K molding or 2K molding. That is into the practice. Okay. So how does it work? The component comes out of the single mold. We have station A. Station A fills component first red, then station B mold rotates by 120. The station B fills the component blue. And station C fills the component green, so as to have the final component. So we have a single machine with the three different barrels, and sequence of the filling is set in such a way that the one material fills sequentially after the other. Okay, and finally the components comes out of the mold and ejected out as a final product. So this is our final component. The first shot would be the light pipe, followed by the second black material button, and followed by the white material on the top of it. Okay, why this material to be white? Because we should have the SOS graphics illumination white color, LED will be transparent, while this light pipe is transparent while LED is in color, so as to have the required red illumination. So this is the application and it sounds interesting, but again, important is material selection. When you are 3K molding, the material what we are selecting for these three parts which are molded sequentially should have good adhesion between them. Okay. Otherwise, the purpose of molding and coming out of one tool and getting separated and non-adhered properly, chemically or physically, that will not have the intent of the design. Okay. So the material we have selected is PC transparent for the light pipe, PC black for the button body, and that of for SOS graphics illumination, PC white. Though all these material are from PC basic material category, their applications are different because diffusivity and transmittance requirement from the indicator and that of SOS illumination different from different, and it is specified by the customer what should be the homogeneity, what should be the candela intensity from the illumination. So we have to select the peculiar material, peculiar grade, which has specific diffusive and transmittive properties. Okay, and we should have good adhesion. So this is the adhesion chart. Here, with respect to application, we have all the materials from the same family, but if the materials calls from the different family, we need to check the adhesion compatibility between the materials. Okay. So what is the secondary process after 1K molding? As I said, there is a lacquering or painting in the control environment, painting followed by controlled curing temperature, and the painted part goes into the lasering station, so has to have the fine lasering at the indicator area and that of SOS graphics illumination up to the reach of the material. So we have the final product. Okay. So this is the process, so as to have the final component, okay, for this part, as per the application for the SOS. So what is the problem in the process, in the painting process? In painting process, if you see this SOS knob, we have this indicator, and in front of indicator, there is a porosity or bubble formation. Okay. And this porosity and bubble formation is not after the molding, it's not observable after the molding. When part is painted and cured, that porosity comes out and forms the bubbles or the aesthetic, which is not acceptable for the product requirement. Okay. So it is a high rejection, 100% rejection you can call, and it's not acceptable for the supplies to the customer. Okay. So what would be the probable causes okay, and what are the recommendations throughout this exercise. So we studied different molding trials and optimization of different process parameters, whether this has an effect with respect to the problems we are facing after the lacquering of painting. But we found that all the process trials, the component we have got has the same results or same rejection or same quality problem. Then lacquering, curing temperature, and control environment as per the process flow chart, as per the specification, we verified the environment for the lacquering and painting, and we found that it is as per the specification that we have defined for this component or product. Okay. Then raw material handling and control, it has a big effect. I mean, humidity and that of your moisture may play important role. If it is carried and molded, then this bubble will come out after the certain heating or certain temperature during the curing. But the environment is quite controlled, and as per process chart definition, whatever the pre-dyeing temperature and that of humidity storage is there for this material to be handled before molding is perfectly handled. So all these criteria are okay. So what would be the problem? I mean, the approach should be different in that case, and we have to go for the part analysis so as to find out the position of the bubble formation, whether it is consistent, random, and then filling study of the part, okay, which is very important with this respect to different molding trial optimizations. Okay, so whether it is giving some interesting pictures, we studied microscopic, we studied this component sections at the microscopic level, and we found that this formation of bubble right in front of the light pipe, and it is consistent over different process parameters. If you change set of parameters, still the bubble formation is more or less at the same area or same location. Okay. You can see this is a white material, top white material, this is a black button material, and this is a light pipe material. In front of it, we can find the bubbles, air bubbles, and we found this very consistent, and we conclude that air bubbles are right next to the light pipe. And filling study, this is very important. You can see that in the filling study, if you check the filling pattern, you can see that this flow is leading. This flow is leading and reaching in front of light pipe by the time this flow leads here. The gate point is here. Okay. So more or less, the different parameters, we found the same filling study pattern. And we found that the side flow is leading fast as compared to top flow because we have low thickness for the elimination area at the top. Okay. And the side flow that is reaching here is formation bubble in front of the light pipe. You can see here. And the problem may have the solution if this formation of the light pipe through the filling is eliminated and the filling pattern is changed from current melt flow to the optimal melt flow. What is optimal melt flow? That we should have this top skin of the component flowing faster than that of the side walls. Okay. So approach mold flow analysis with the current design to correlate the filling study. Then design modification to achieve optimal flow pattern because we cannot go blindly. Then study of mold flow parameters as effect of change in design. If you are changing so as to achieve one parameter that is optimal flow, what effect it has on the other parameters which are important for the product application. So we cannot leave that. To study best design modification to implement into the tool changes, we have to modify the tool according to the results we have got. And tool modification as per the optimal filling pattern that we have received, and what is the current status with the modified sample. We have to review again with the same procedure after the molding with the modification of the tool. So this was the approach, okay. And what are the design modification that can help us so as to control the side flow and so as to enhance the top flow, right? So we are interested in the filling pattern of the white component. So as to restrict the flow in the side walls, we should restrict this side areas to flow into the white components. That means we have to increase the rib height in the black component, right? When the top black component rib height will increase, it will decrease the thickness in the white component. Maybe that will help us to solve the problem, okay? Or what we can do, in addition to this, we can have increase in the rib width. This increase in rib width we reduce the thickness in this area, in the component, white component, okay. So altogether, our intent is to control the side flow and enhance the top flow, so that by the time the top flow reaches the light pipe, the side flow should be around somewhere rest tracking with respect to flow velocity of the top flow. Okay. So with the changes, what are the changes in the thickness of the top white metal? Here it was 1.2 before we increased the rib height of the black metal by 0.8. It is 1.4. This was 0.75 before complete. We reduced it to 0.55. So we have the design modification as per our intent, so as to have the optimal flow, right? So when you go with this design modification into the filling pattern, for the initial filling, we can see that yes, there is a trace that is leading in with respect to the velocity, and this flow is going ahead with respect to the side flow. But it's not clear with these two pictures. Okay, when you go into the 60% and 80% of the filling inside the cavity, we can see that this is leading faster. This is also leading faster as compared to this, while that of this is exactly correlating with the actual filling images. Okay, so existing design, whenever we are going to change the design, first we have to ensure that what it is behaving in mold flow with respect to existing design, it is exactly the same what we are getting into the actual samples, then only we can implement for the next design changes. So it is being nearly the same or exactly the same as per the air trap in front of the light pipe. So with the 60% illumination, you can see that the filling pattern what we are getting here and that of here, okay, and here. Here we are getting the rest track here, and it is formation bombing bubble or air trap in front of the light pipe, while in this case and in this second and first and second modification case, the top skin is hitting first to the light pipe and then the side flows are coming in. So we can say that the design content or design modification is working, okay, with respect to the optimal flow. Also, you can see that this area should always fill in the velocity phase, but you can see that in the VP switch where it is still unfilled. Means during the VP, it may be the chance that part is not filling completely there. There may be pores in front of the light pipe. So this is a condition that correlates to the actual samples, okay. Now, in the next case, as this is filling in the velocity phase, we don't have any issue because only this much area is remaining to fill into the packing phase, okay. So with respect to this correlation also, we are green in modification one and modification two, okay, with respect to the air trap formation in front of light pipe. So what are the filling concern? Part is filling under packing pressure in front of light pipe in existing design and possibility of short filling forming the pores. Here the flow lead towards the center are improved, but we have the formation of well-line or aesthetic surface. This is not acceptable in modified one case. While in modified two case, the optimal flow point is achieved, no well line, no aesthetic defects, and the flow is reaching light pipe well before the side flow reaches the light pipe area. So we can say that in terms of filling pattern, modified two is very good option for us. What about the filling pressure? Because reducing in the thickness, we see that there is a small increase in pressure values, but these pressure values are well within the limit for the machine that we are going to mold this part on, okay. So that is not a problem. And what is the effect on flow temperature? Yes, because of reduction thickness, the drop in temperature is there, but this drop in temperature is within limit of the material. It is still in the flowable conditions. We can go ahead with this also. What is the stress, shear stress? This is important. Because in existing case, shear stress is blue, I mean, well within the recommended limit, while because of decrease in thickness, it is slightly increasing the limit for the material, that is 0.5 MPa. And this flow-induced stress may relax or release during the curing or during the storage temperature, and it may have the effect of deformation or somewhat like that, which can be identified later after the validation, not exactly before. So with respect to shear stress, as only the concern point for this modification, as we have got good optimal flow for the modified 1 and 2 case, and it's correlating with respect to the air trap formation in 1 and 2, there is no air trap formation in front of light pipe, we can say that the conclusion we have with existing modified 1 and modified 2 can see in existing filling is not good. Rest all the parameters are okay, but we have the bubble formation after the curing. In modified one and modified two, we have filling good, propellant temperature good, pressure good. In modified one, we have well line, so it's not acceptable. But in last, the optimal flow pattern is okay. Only thing is we have shear stress slightly higher than that of the material limit. So we can give the inference, mole flow inference or conclusion like that. And out of these three cases, modified 2K shows high flow induced stress, but the tool can be modified with that so as to check the effect in validation, but the bubble formation issue will be solved. And with this consideration, we had gone ahead and done the modification in the tool, and we got the new samples after the tool modification exactly as per the modified tool design. And the impression, I mean, tool modification with this case should be truly verified and discussed to avoid temperature validation failures due to the increase in shear stress. That was the final comment from the mole flow team to the tool manufacturing team. But considering the case, considering the risk, we have gone ahead. And what are the feedbacks we have got after the sampling? That due to small wall thickness of the white component, a lot of heat and shear is generated in this area, exactly the way we identified into the mole flow. And this is causing black component mixing with the white component during the molding because of high shear heat generation. This is only concern there is after the molding. And they painted the part, they gone to the lacquering painting, and they don't have any issue with the bubble formation and part with no bubble formation. And this white mixing with the white component mixing with the black component mixing on the sideways and doesn't have any effect on the illumination area, which is going to remain white. Okay. So as per this feedback, we have got these images showing a partial mixing of black with white, but it has no effect after the validation also with respect to the relaxing out and deformation or temperature failures in the component, and perfectly okay being PC as a material, it can sustain with respect to that temperatures. Okay. And we have got the component okay and a green with this all exercise. And believe me, this is a tool where one can always approach before touching the actual tool modification. Okay. Because tool is ready and the cost involved for the modification is very high. Sometimes if you modify with respect to your, I mean, experience is always there with respect to your thinking. If you modify and it doesn't work out, then that is additional cost for your next iteration. So always it is better to go through the mole flow inference, have a confidence that what is the solution, how it is behaving, and what problems we can face after this modification. And we can always get a current status as a green status. Maybe we have to iterate further. This case study we iterated 3 times, as you see, existing modified and modified two, and we are given the final conclusion that modified two is the right modification for this problem, and it has helped us a lot. Okay, thank you. This brings to the end of this presentation of this case study. It is simple correlation study, so as to have the confidence what we are doing in simulation and what is there into the actual. Any question answers? Yeah. Okay. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Autodex, for considering for this platform.
Thank you, Mr. Sriheri.
And giving an opportunity to present myself here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mr. Sriheri. That was a very, very detailed session on mole flow, and your experience really shows in there. And we would still encourage you to be on our user communities and conferences and all that, because this is what the community would need hear from you more and more.
Sure.
With that, I'll welcome my colleague, Mr. Kamalakannan, to facilitate Mr. Sriheri. Yeah. Okay. You come in front of you.